Good day, viewers. Welcome to another edition of the Daily Strange Stories. I'm John Brown. Our lead story for today. Meet Mark Shuttleworth, the South African billionaire who gave his maid and gardener 1 million rand bonuses. In the annals of South African history, few figures stand as tall and as intriguing as Mark Shuttleworth. Born on the 18th of September 1973, in the unassuming town of Welkom, his journey from a bright-eyed schoolboy to a pioneering tech entrepreneur, a space explorer, and a generous philanthropist is nothing short of extraordinary. This is the story of Mark Shuttleworth, a man who dared to dream beyond the confines of Earth and whose actions continue to inspire a nation. Shuttleworth's early life offered few hints of the remarkable path he would eventually tread. Raised in Cape Town, he attended Western Province Preparatory School and later Bishop's College, a prestigious institution where he distinguished himself as head boy in 1991. These formative years instilled in him a strong work ethic and a thirst for knowledge, qualities that would serve him well in his future endeavors. After completing his secondary education, Shuttleworth enrolled at the University of Cape Town, pursuing a Bachelor of Business Science degree in Finance and Information Systems. It was during his time at university that his entrepreneurial spirit truly began to ignite. In 1995, while still a student, he founded Thawte Consulting, a technology company that would soon revolutionize the world of internet security. Thawte's initial focus quickly shifted to addressing the growing need for secure electronic commerce. Recognizing the potential of the burgeoning online marketplace, Shuttleworth and his team developed innovative solutions to protect sensitive data transmitted over the internet. Thawte became the first company to produce a full security e-commerce web server that was commercially available outside the United States, a groundbreaking achievement that catapulted the company onto the global stage. This pioneering work led Thawte into the realm of public key infrastructure, the fundamental technology underpinning encrypted and authenticated internet transactions. As the internet continued to expand, the demand for secure online communication soared, and Thawte found itself at the forefront of this technological revolution. By December 1999, Thawte had become the fastest-growing internet certificate authority and the leading certificate authority outside of the US. The company's success attracted the attention of VeriSign, a US-based internet security giant. In a landmark deal, Shuttleworth sold Thawte to VeriSign for a staggering $575 million, equivalent to our $10.3 billion in 2025, instantly transforming him into one of the world's youngest billionaires. With his newfound wealth, Shuttleworth embarked on a new chapter, driven by a desire to foster innovation and support emerging entrepreneurs. In 2000, he established HBD Venture Capital, Here Be Dragons, a venture capital firm dedicated to providing funding and mentorship to innovative startups. However, Shuttleworth's passion for open-source software soon led him in a different direction. In 2004, he founded Canonical Limited, a company with a bold mission to make computing accessible and free for everyone, particularly in developing countries. Canonical's flagship product, the Ubuntu operating system, quickly gained popularity for its user-friendly interface, its commitment to open-source principles, and its focus on social impact through technology. Ubuntu aimed to empower individuals and communities by providing them with access to a powerful and versatile operating system without the financial barriers associated with proprietary software. This vision resonated deeply with Shuttleworth, who saw technology as a tool for social change and economic empowerment. But Shuttleworth's ambitions extended far beyond the realm of technology. In 2002, he captured the world's imagination by becoming the first African in space. This extraordinary feat was self-funded, costing Shuttleworth approximately $20 million and requiring nearly a year of rigorous training. The journey began with a flight aboard the Russian Soyuz TM-34 mission to the International Space Station, ISS. On the 25th of April 2002, Shuttleworth lifted off from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan, accompanied by two cosmonauts, Commander Yuri Gidzenko of Russia and Flight Engineer Roberto Vittori of Italy. During his 8 days aboard the ISS, Shuttleworth conducted scientific experiments for South Africa, contributing to research in areas such as biotechnology and materials science. He also used his time in space to promote science education and inspire young people across Africa. From space, Shuttleworth spoke via video link to Thabo Mbeki, then president of South Africa, as part of the Freedom Day celebrations marking the end of apartheid. He also had a radio conversation with Nelson Mandela, a moment that symbolized the hopes and aspirations of a newly democratic nation. Upon returning to Earth, Shuttleworth traveled extensively, sharing his experiences with schoolchildren around the world and advocating for the importance of science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, STEM, education. However, it was an act of extraordinary generosity that truly cemented Shuttleworth's legacy in the hearts of many. Upon selling Thawte in 1999, he decided to share his wealth with those who had contributed to the company's success. He awarded each of his 57 employees a 1 million rand Christmas bonus, an unprecedented gesture of gratitude that made headlines around the world. What made this act even more remarkable was that it extended to all staff members, including two office cleaners and a gardener. Shuttleworth recognized that every individual, regardless of their role, had played a part in Thawte's success, and he wanted to ensure that everyone benefited equally from the company's windfall. For many of the recipients, the 1 million rand bonus was life-changing. It provided them with financial security, enabling them to invest in homes, education, and a better future for their families. Shuttleworth's generosity served as a powerful reminder of the importance of valuing every team member and the positive ripple effects that such recognition can have. As of 2025, Mark Shuttleworth continues to lead Canonical as its CEO, guiding the company through the ever-evolving landscape of open-source software. Under his leadership, Ubuntu has maintained its position as a leading Linux distribution, focusing on cloud computing, IoT, and enterprise solutions. Shuttleworth currently resides in London, but he maintains a strong connection to his homeland. He also maintains a presence on the Isle of Man and holds dual citizenship in South Africa and the United Kingdom. His commitment to social innovation was evident through initiatives like the Shuttleworth Foundation, which, before its closure in 2024, provided fellowships to individuals working on transformative ideas in education and technology. The Shuttleworth Foundation supported a diverse range of projects, from developing open-source educational resources to promoting digital literacy in underserved communities. Beyond his corporate responsibilities, Shuttleworth remains a passionate advocate for open-source principles and equitable access to technology. He believes that technology has the power to transform lives and create a more just and equitable world, and he continues to work tirelessly to make that vision a reality. In recent years, Shuttleworth has turned his attention to environmental conservation and sustainable tourism. He invested in the island of Príncipe, part of São Tomé and Príncipe, aiming to transform it into a model for ecotourism. Described as the Galapagos of Africa, Príncipe's rich biodiversity and pristine landscapes have benefited from Shuttleworth's efforts to promote responsible tourism and protect natural habitats. He has worked with local communities to develop sustainable tourism initiatives that generate income while preserving the island's natural beauty. Thank you for watching this news video. We'd love to hear what you think about this story, so please leave your comments below. We read them all and appreciate your insights. Join us again in our next strange story. Until then, goodbye.